हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन, फिट एंड सेफ एट योर होम एंड टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ। वेलकम बैक इन योर मैथ्स क्लास, क्लास फिफ्थ, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, चैप्टर वन। नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मेजरमेंट एंड दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 5। Today's subtopics are operations involving metric measures. Operations involving metric measures. मेट्रिक मेजर्स, इट बेसिकली कंटेन्स योर सम्स रिलेटेड टू एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन। ओके, यू विल स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 1D। Questions three, four, five, and 11. These questions we will do. Along with this, we will do homework discussion of previous lecture. In today's lecture, we will consider addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction. So let's start exercise 1D and question number 3. Question number 3 is, Reena walked 2 kilometers in the morning and 3,000 meters in the evening. What is the distance covered by Reena in kilometer? First of all, you have to understand the question. Reena walked 2 kilometers in the morning, 3,000 meters in the evening. She walked 2 kilometers in the morning and 3,000 meters. Have you seen that here unit is given kilometer and here it is meter? What is the distance covered by Reena in kilometer? We have to tell that how much total distance is covered by Reena. But the answer is needed in kilometer. So first of all, we have to do this conversion. Conversion of 3,000 meter into kilometer. And after that, we will do addition. Got it? So first of all, you will write down 1 meter. You all know 1 meter is equal to 1 upon 1,000 kilometer. So write down whatever is given to us. 1 meter is equal to 1/1000 kilometer. Now you know this from King Harry died. Mother did not cry much. Okay. We have to convert 3000 meter. So now here it will become 3000 in next step. So 3000 meter is equal to 3000/1000 kilometer. Three zeros will cancel. So it will become 3 kilometer. So we got our answer that 3000 meter means 3 kilometer. Now we will do our statement. Now write down. Reena walked in the morning is equal to 2 kilometer. Right? And Reena walked in the evening is equal to 3000 meter is equal to 3 kilometer. Right? Distance covered by Reena. Distance covered by Reena. Distance covered is the total distance. So we will do addition. 2 + 3. 5 kilometer is the total distance covered by Reena. So our answer will become 5 kilometer. Next question is question number 4. Banu bought 4 meter of ribbon and Ranjan bought, these are the names, Banu and Ranjan. Ranjan bought 2000 centimeter of ribbon. Right. Who bought more? Who bought more and by how much? We have done these type of questions in our chapter of whole numbers also and in fraction also. Banu bought 4 meters of ribbon and Ranjan bought 2000 centimeters of ribbon. Who bought more and by how much? Here it is centimeter and here it is meter. First of all, we will do conversion. Either meter will be converted in centimeter or we can convert centimeter into meter. Now let's start solution. 1 centimeter is equal to dash meter. Will be 1/100 and now 2000 centimeter is equal to 2000/100 meter. Cancel these zeros. Two zeros will cancel. 20 meter. 2000 centimeter is equal to 20 meter. Now write down the statement. Banu bought ribbon is equal to 4 meter and Ranjan bought ribbon is equal to 2000 centimeter. It has become now 20 मीटर. क्वेश्चन वॉज देयर हु बॉट मोर एंड बाय हाउ मच. इट मीन्स वी विल डू कंपेरिजन. ओके, कंपेरिजन बानु एंड रंजन. रिबन 4 मीटर, 20 मीटर इज बॉट. हु बॉट मोर? रंजन हैज बॉट मोर. सो यू विल राइट डाउन, रंजन बॉट 4 रिबन. एंड नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज बाय हाउ मच. सो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल डू सब्ट्रैक्शन. नाउ 20 मीटर माइनस 4 मीटर इज इक्वल टू 16 मीटर. सो राइट डाउन मोर रिबन बॉट बाय रंजन इज इक्वल टू 16 मीटर. रंजन हैज बॉट 16 मीटर मोर रिबन देन बानु. गॉट इट? नाउ अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. रिबन वाज 23.7 मीटर लॉन्ग. दिस क्वेश्चन इज अगेन ऑफ रिबन. इट वॉज कट इन टू 4 पीसेस ऑफ. नाउ लेंथ इज गिवन ऑफ द पीसेस 3.9 मीटर, 14.2 मीटर, 2.9 मीटर एंड 1.08 मीटर. फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द रिमेनिंग रिबन. Length of the remaining. Length of the remaining ribbon. First of all, you have to understand the question. Total length of the ribbon is given. It is cut down into pieces. We have length of 4 pieces. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Find the length of the remaining ribbon. It means there is some more part of the ribbon which is left. We have to find out that. Look here, beta. You can understand this question very easily from this graph. This is the total length of the ribbon. 23.7 meters. And it is cut down into 5 pieces. Length of first piece, second piece, third piece, and fourth piece is given to us. Length of fifth piece we have to find out. These are the approximate, so it is not measured exactly using scale. It is only the chart which will explain you the question. Okay. So first of all, we will do addition of these 4 pieces of ribbon. Then we will subtract from the total length of the ribbon. The answer which we will get is the length of remaining piece of the ribbon. Understood? So start statement now. Total length of 4 pieces of ribbon is equal to do addition. 3 decimal, 9 meter, 14 decimal, 2 meter, 0 will be written here, 2 decimal, 9 meter, and 1 decimal, 0, 8 meter. So here also 0. Right. Now we will do addition. Unit will be written very, very carefully. 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 8. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 9, 20. 0. 2 will be here, carry. 3 plus 4, 7. 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. 2, put a decimal here. And 1 here, carry. 1 plus 1, 2. 22 decimal, 0, 8 meter. Now there is subtraction part. So write down. Length of the ribbon is equal to 23 decimal 7 meter. Length of 4 pieces of ribbon is equal to 22 decimal 0, 08 meter. Length of the remaining piece of ribbon is equal to, we will find out the length of the remaining piece of the ribbon by subtraction. 23 decimal 7 meter, 22 decimal 0, 08 meters. So write 0. Subtraction. 0 minus 8, not possible. So it will take 4. 0 will become 10, 7 will become 6. 10 minus 8, 2. Write unit carefully. 6 minus 0, 6. Put decimal. 3 minus 2, 1. 2 minus 2, 0. So length of the ribbon is 1 decimal 62 meter. This is the length of the remaining piece. Okay. Next question is question number 11. Lily bought 18. Can, tin can, it is tin can, whose capacity was 50 liter. She poured 10 liter of water, 13 liter of lime juice, 23 liter of sugar solution. What capacity of tin had शी यूज्ड अप. सो क्वेश्चन इज हियर, लिली बॉट अ टीन कैन 50 लीटर कैपेसिटी. 50 लीटर इज द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द टीन कैन विच शी हैज बॉट. नाउ शी हैज पॉट 10 लीटर ऑफ वॉटर, 13 लीटर ऑफ लाइम जूस एंड 23 लीटर ऑफ शुगर सॉल्यूशन. व्हाट कैपेसिटी ऑफ द टीन हैड शी यूज्ड अप. लिली ने कितना टीन का स्पेस मींस कैपेसिटी क्षमता यूज कर ली. ओके, मींस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द टोटल कैपेसिटी ऑफ दीज लिक्विड्स पोर्ड बाय लिली. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द सॉल्यूशन. वाटर वाटर पोर्ड 10 और यू कैन राइट डाउन लिली पोर्ड वॉटर 10 दैट इज ऑल्सो ओके. वाटर पोर्ड 10 लीटर. लाइम जूस पोर्ड 10 लाइम जूस 13 लीटर एंड शुगर सॉल्यूशन poured in the tin 23 liter. Capacity of the tin used up 0 plus 3 3 3 plus 3 6 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 4. 46 liter capacity is used. Now it's time to take homework. Homework is solve questions 7 to 9 of exercise 1D in notebook. Definitely in math notebook you will do, no? Now we will do homework discussion of lecture 4. So take out your notebooks. You have to match your solutions and do correction if your solutions are wrong. Question number 5 and 6 were given. Question number 5 was express 93 liter into 1 dL, centiliter and milliliter. Express or convert. Everything is written. You have to match only. Now let's start solution. 1 liter is equal to 10 deciliter and the given question is 93 liter is equal to 93 multiplied 10 deciliter. It will become 930 deciliter. Okay. Now the B part is convert 93 liter into centiliter. 1 liter is equal to 100 centiliter and 93 liter is equal to 93 multiply 100. So directly you can write down 9300 centiliter. If you are writing a 93 multiply 100, that is also correct. But oral answer also you know how to do. Okay. And C part. Convert 93 liter into milliliter. So write down 1 liter 1000 milliliter. 93 liter is equal to 93 multiply by 1000. Now 93 and 3 zeros will be there. Once 10's 100,000, 10,000, it will become 93,000 milliliter. क्वेश्चन वाज क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एक्सप्रेस 49,018 लीटर इंटू डेकालीटर, हेक्टोलीटर एंड किलोलीटर. सो राइट डाउन द फॉर्मूला. फर्स्ट, 1 लीटर इज इक्वल टू 1/10 डेकालीटर. 49,018 लीटर इज इक्वल टू 49,018/10. आई एम शोइंग यू दिस स्टेप ऑल्सो बिकॉज सम स्टूडेंट्स आर गेटिंग प्रॉब्लम इन डिवीजन बाय 1000 और 1000. 10 इज देयर, सो वंस प्लेस एंड पुट नाउ डेसिमल हेयर बिफोर वंस प्लेस, इट विल बिकम 4901.8. सो वट वी विल रीड, 4901.8 डेकालीटर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज कन्वर्ट लीटर इंटू हेक्टोलीटर. राइट डाउन द फॉर्मूला. 1 लीटर इज इक्वल टू 1/100 हेक्टोलीटर. 49,018 लीटर इज इक्वल टू 49,018/100 हेक्टोलीटर. Now denominator is containing 2 zeros. So once tens, before tens we will put decimal. It will become 490.18 hectoliter. What we will read? 490.18 hectoliter. And the next part is convert into kiloliter. So 1 liter is equal to 1/1000 kiloliter. And 49,018 liter is equal to 49,018/1000 kiloliter. 1, 2, 3 zeros in denominator. 1, 2, 3, or we can say 1, 10, 100. Put decimal here. It will become 49.018 kiloliter. Have you checked your answers? You need to cross check this and do correction if needed. That's all for today. Kindly like our videos and subscribe our channel. Thank you and have a nice day.